up, Fabrication Nation? Welcome to the channel. Today, I think I'm going to spend a little bit of time and go over pie cutting. So, the popular thing these days is to pie cut tubing to make bends. Not necessarily my preferred method of welding or making bends, but that doesn't mean that it's not a good way of doing it. And I get a lot of questions about how to do it. So, without going into great detail, I'm gonna spend a little bit of time, show you how, give you some pointers, give you some guidelines to go by when doing pie cut bends, and maybe show you something that you didn't already know. All right, so pie cutting, creating bends with pie cuts, is for you, for anybody out there that doesn't know, it's basically taking sections of straight tubing, cutting them in a pie shape, and then when you stack them together, you can actually create nice, smooth bends. Okay? Now, obviously you could just go start cutting all kinds of pie-shaped pieces of tubing and weld them together and you'd have a pie cut. But there is kind of a proper way to do this. A professional way to do this. I don't really prefer pie cuts myself, so I'm not necessarily an expert on this. I usually just go with a mandrel bent tube. I buy mandrel bends and then put those bends together to achieve what it is that I want to achieve. Just because I don't prefer it doesn't mean it's not a good method. There are some pros and some cons to pie cutting and mandrel bends both. There's also a place for pie cutting. There's certain instances where you can't necessarily bend tube, mandrel bend tube to the radius that you need, or the material itself is not very bendable. And in those cases, pie cutting is a must. There are actually several companies already out there that do pre-cut pie cutting for you. Most of it's laser cut, it's very precise and exact. One of those companies is called Tycon. Tycon basically does titanium tubing of all sorts. You can see mandrel bent stuff, tubing, exhaust, anything you basically need they can do for you. The reason I bring them up is because they do offer a sample kit. So they offer sample pieces of titanium that are already pie cut. It's a very well-priced kit. They're not very expensive. And in those kits, they'll send you some filler rod, some pieces of pie cut tubing in different sizes, and some pieces of titanium plate. So if titanium is something that you wanted to experiment with, you can go get one of these sample kits from them. All this is unpackaged, but when you get it, it will be nice and sealed and packaged up pretty. Tycon, tyconindustries.com. They actually sent me this kit. I plan to experiment with it at some point. Never really tried my hand at titanium. I'm gonna give it a try and maybe use it for like wastegate tube on the bibster or something where it's nice and clean and cool. As long as I can pull it off. All right, so let's talk about some of the pros and some of the cons to pie cutting. Some of the pros would be you can get tighter radiuses than you might be able to get with mandrel bending. You can use materials that maybe aren't very good at bending, like the material itself might be too brittle to bend it. So if you pie cut it, you can actually achieve what you're looking for. In some instances, it might be cheaper to buy straight tubing and pie cut it and create your bends versus buying a mandrel bent tube. All right, so now let's get into some of the basic theories of pie cutting and kind of the right way to do it. So pretty much what the standard is either a 9-degree pie cut, so 4.5 degrees off either side of center. So if this is a tube and you mark a center line, you wanna go 4.5 degrees one way, 4.5 degrees the other way, and you have a 9-inch pie cut. The other way is an 18-degree pie cut. So if this was a straight tube, you'd have a 9-degree cut and a 9-degree cut equaling a total of an 18-degree pie cut. The reason that these are pretty standard is because you can achieve the angles that you want, the easy angles, very simply. So if you have a 9-degree pie cut, 10 of these makes 90 degrees. It's easy for you to do that. Five of them would make a 45-degree. And then basically the same thing when you have an 18-degree pie cut. It'll only take 5 of these to make a 90 degree angle. And you can see when you use a 9 degree pie cut, when you stack several of these together, you can actually make a very nice smooth radius on the inside. Some of the other pros are you don't get any shrinkage through the bend. So even in mandrel bent tubing, you do get some shrinkage through the bend itself. In pie cuts, you don't get that. These are all straight tube. So if this is a 2.5 inch tube, you're gonna get a true 2.5 inch degree radius through the bend. Some of the downfalls to pie cutting, obviously the labor, you have to cut and weld so many little pieces. It's kind of a disadvantage. Another pro to pie cutting is you really kind of have unlimited access to clocking of angles. So as you are doing a bend, you can start to rotate these and create all kinds of complex curves and bends that wouldn't necessarily be as easy to do with mandrel bends. You could chop them out and basically pie cut the mandrel bends themselves, but wouldn't be as easy as doing these. That's enough about these. Let's go over here to the bench and I'll kind of show you how you want to lay these out in a fashion that's going to give you the same cut, repeatability, and allow you to make really nice lobster or pie cuts. All right, let's lay something out here to scribble on. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to give you the very basics to the proper way, or at least a good starting point to lay out tube for pie cuts. So the first thing that you need to do is you need to figure out the distance around your tube, right? So what you want to do is you want to measure the diameter of the tube, which is obviously the distance across the tube itself. So from one side to the other, the diameter. And on this one, we're gonna say it's 4.5. So 4.5 is the diameter. And you wanna multiply that by pi, which is 3.14. That is gonna give us 14.13. So 14.13 is the circumference around this tube. All right. What we want to find out is we want to find the halfway mark, perfectly halfway through this tube here. So what we're going to do is we're going to take 14.13, we're going to split that in half, we're going to divide that in half. It's going to give us 7.065. Okay, so we know that 7.065 inches around this tube from this point here is gonna be perfectly halfway around. So that's gonna give you basically your perfect halfway through this tube. Now, the reason that you wanna know this is because this is gonna be critical as far as cutting and lining up the tubes themselves, because we're going to mark the tube halfway. So you can see these marks on this tube here. That is the halfway mark. When you mark the tube halfway before you cut it, it allows you to cut those angles perfectly square, okay, every time. And once they're cut, it's going to allow you, once you line these up, you know that you're going to have a perfect 90 degree bend. It's not going to waver any as it bends, as long as those line up. It'll also allow you to clock these things purposely, right? So these here were hand marked before they were cut. If you get them from Tycon or a company like that, a lot of times they'll have a weld seam on the inside. They have a weld seam on the inside here. As long as you line up that weld seam, you know that it's going to be exactly the same throughout that bend. All right, so using this formula, you take a long straight piece of tube, which essentially would look like that, right? So essentially that's what that tube looked like before it was cut. It was a straight tube, got a line drawn down this side, got another line drawn on the other side of the tube that is perfectly opposite of this line. And all you have to do is chuck that thing up in your bandsaw or whatever you're going to use to cut it. Make sure that this side is perfectly the highest point up. And then just start cutting. 4.5 degrees, 4.5 degrees, 4.5 degrees, 4.5 degrees. In a perfect world, you kind of want these inside pieces here to match. So you want all the inside distances to match or be very close. And if you take that straight tube and cut it up into a bunch of pie cuts that are exactly the same, you will then be able to put these together and make nice pie cut bends. So you can see how that works. Once again, measure the diameter of the tube, times it by pi, 3.14, that's gonna give you the circumference. Split that in half, that's gonna give you your perfect halfway point. Once you figure that out, draw lines down the entire length of the tube that are opposite of each other. You want them to be perfectly opposite of each other. And then just go down and cut. Once you've done that, you've got all your pie cuts, then you can kind of put those together as needed. Usually you'll just want to tack it together as you create it. And then once you have what you want, then you can go back and weld it all up. All right, guys, there you go. A very easy introduction to pie cutting and making pie cut bends. That's the way you want to do it. Those are the basics of it. The rest of it you can kind of figure out on your own. There are some very in-depth videos on YouTube about pie cutting if you kind of want to look into it more. I know the fabrication series does one. I'll put maybe a link to that video in the description. If you're not familiar with that channel, you can go check it out. Like I said, that's the basics there. That's all you really need to know to get started and make nice, professional, clean-looking pie cut bends. I hope you guys enjoyed that. As always, thank you for joining me, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Go do work, son.